Good morning, students. Let us start sexual reproduction in flowering plants. All flowering plants show sexual reproduction. You have read in previous class asexual reproduction. Now sexual reproduction. The reproduction which occurs by the formation and fusion of gametes is called sexual reproduction. So in flowering plants, flower is the most important. So first we have to know what is flower. So flower is a modified shoot which serves the reproduction. There are many uses of flowers. Flowers are the aspects of social, religious, cultural value. Again, flowers are the objects of social, religious, ornamental, and cultural value. Besides these, flowers are being used by human to express love, affection, grief, and mourning. In this way, there are many uses of flowers it has many importance. Now start a typical diagram of flower. Here it is a typical flower. It is a stalk of the flower. It is called pedicel. So pedicel is the stalk of the flower. Some flower have pedicel, that flower is called pedicellate, and some flower have no pedicel, that is called sessile. And there this swollen portion, upper swollen portion of pedicel is thalamus, where all organs of flower like calyx, corolla, endosium and gynosium are attached. Thalamus. The upper swollen portion of pedicel, where after this, we will read all organs of flower alternately. Sorry, simultaneously. So there are four organs of flower. Calyx is the outermost organ of the flower. It is made up of many sepals. Sepal is the unit of calyx. simple unit of helix. Suppose this class is made up of 40 students, and out of 40, one student represent 40 students are galax, and one student represent sepal. So sepal is the unit of galax. It is green in color. It protects the internal organ of the flower. So it is called protect. So it is called helping organ of the flower. Next, corolla. Corolla is the second organ of the flower. It is made up of many petals. So petal is the unit of corolla. Corolla are colored. So insects are attracted. And it helps in cross pollination.